Annapolis legislators today got a timely briefing on the status of gaming in Maryland, and it comes as lawmakers consider table games. Tomorrow, ground will be broken for a casino at Arundel Mills Mall, and the update comes as Rosecroft Raceway in Prince George's County goes on the auction block Friday. 11 News reporter David Collins is following all of these developments live from the State House. David?
And as if that weren't enough, the O'Malley administration made a surprise announcement during the briefing, much to the dismay of legislators. The O'Malley administration announced that slots proceeds may continue to subsidize Maryland horse racing for years to come.
And they're off.
The finish line is still nowhere in sight. Maryland horse racing is counting on the General Assembly to continue subsidizing the industry with slots revenues until it figures out a way to save itself. Last month, the O'Malley administration approved a short-term fix. The Maryland Economic Development Corp, known as MEDCO, loaned track operators $3.6 million toward operating costs. The money will be repaid by the state using slots revenue intended for thoroughbred track improvements. The authority for the transfer requires a provision in the Annual Budget Act, which must be approved by the General Assembly. The Senate Budget and Tax Committee is now hearing that the administration will be introducing a bill allowing the subsidy to continue for a few more years.
Letting them go into the racetrack facility account to help maintain a racing calendar of 146 days.
While this is just a Band-Aid on an arterial bleed, perhaps.
Another committee member questioned the sanity of rewarding those he suspects who are currently trying to stop the flow of slots revenues in the state by attempting to delay the opening of the Maryland Live Casino at Arundel Mills Mall.
We're giving them $3.6 million, and they're trying to prevent money going to the state.
I don't think we ever looked at it as we're giving XYZ Corporation money. We looked at it as we need to find a way to keep these people employed, keep the open space.
Another committee member expressed frustration over the Penn National Maryland Jockey Club partnership.
This ownership situation has to be resolved. Who calls the shot?
A similar slot subsidy plan is being drafted regarding bankrupt Rosecroft Raceway. The harness track is on the auction block. A new round of bidding is scheduled for Friday.
We would authorize a MEDCO loan up to $4 million to be paid out of the purse supplements.
Legislation just introduced in the Senate would expand gaming to allow table games.
Basically, we have those things at some of our facilities. So what's the difference?
Unfortunately, this issue's got to go back to referendum, and so nothing will be decided until 2012.
Groundbreaking for a casino at Arundel Mills Malls is scheduled for tomorrow. Now, the bill, maybe there will be more bills, to be introduced that would divert slots proceeds to track operating costs are expected to be introduced in a couple of weeks. Reporting live from Annapolis, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.